Chin at a big event. Mayor Turner made a big fancy speech, and I'm trying to remember what that banquet was. Was that the AI? It was a big fancy deal. And everyone was all, gussied up and everything, and I was introduced to Ms. Chin, and she was introduced to me as this daughter of an amazing painter. And I said, well, I like paintings. And so that process began to where her work that she has been displaying of her father's was made further aware to us as we have connected. And so we are very, very blessed to have this exhibit in Precinct 4 in our Tracy G. Center. Can we have a round of applause for these pieces are right here in the middle of our center, and I have all kinds of cool things to talk about on your father. And the question is, do I steal your thunder, or do I let you talk about your dad yourself from the heart? And I'm thinking that it would be best for me to let you share from your heart, because the knowledge that I have here is just amazing with regard to the work and how, as a child, one of the things I found fascinating is he would go and pick up sticks, and then he would charcoal them so that he could have the charcoal to draw his paintings with, because he didn't have, and then he would do things to sell that he could then buy the paper to do his sketches. The charcoal sketches, it was real charcoal, homemade charcoal. That is a passion for art, and we now get to have the benefit. As time grew on and this experience grew, we end up with greater and greater work that can make us breathe and smile. And I have here, I was looking through them. This one I think is my favorite because I like rural scenes. And you can buy the book and buy the paintings back in the back. This one is a road, which is a country road, with mountains in the background and trees. And it makes me feel, I have a country upbringing, and it makes me feel home. And home is a beautiful feeling to have. We can feel at home wherever we are if we look at one of these paintings. We have in our midst a celebrity, and her name is Alice Lee, and she is going to be our...
It's like the... so upscale today. Normally they'll have classes here and it's really loud and noisy, but today, what a wonderful occasion. Thank you so much for bringing us all together. I just really want to acknowledge that we really have a great county commissioner, Mr. Cable. Because of the redistricting effort, he has made so much of a personal effort to come to every corner of his new precinct, newly drawn district, that we have seen so much more of Commissioner Cable than we have of our previous commissioner. Not to fault him or anything, but it's just that he has really made it a personal passion and commitment to reach out to every one of his constituent groups. And to that, let's give him a big round of applause. Him at so many events that my husband's like, well, who are you going to see again today? So we really want to acknowledge Commissioner Cable. We have visited many times in the past, and I remember that he has top three priorities are public safety, parks, and then also partnerships. So today is an example of the partnership that he has with our very diverse community. And I don't want to take up any more time, but I do want to thank Ms. Yvonne Chen for honoring the memory of her father and the wonderful artwork that he has provided us. And for many of us in this room, these artworks were done way before probably photography or anything that you can digitize. So, and it really depicts the actual life. The structures and some of the buildings are still there, but it's the special scenery that he depicts that you probably won't be able to see, because also some of these areas have been torn down or there's new development there. So that is really something that historically, we should really praise the work of Yvonne's father. So thank you all very much for being here, and thank you for this great opportunity.
Pleasure to welcome the man that many call the mayor of Chinatown, Mr. Kenneth Lee.
In all this volunteer work, actually is serving our Commissioner Cagle. I have to thank Commissioner Cagle once, you know, he was serving this area, overseeing in every important community event. So I want to thank to offer this opportunity to the public over here. Tracy G is one of the important, I think, county facilities for many, many of us, including polling, voting, and now we have found another function is culture thing, you know. I want to thank Yvonne, you know, to offer, because I was born in Taiwan, and probably know that Double 10 is National Day of Republic of China and Taiwan, which is celebrated the past Monday. So I think this art exhibit actually to showcase the people that, you know, what Taiwan used to look like, and it's a famous, you know, for its freedom and then the painting. So we can enjoy that. I want to thank, you know, Alice Lee. I mean, as you know, been serving for the district before, and many, many of us, you know. And at the back, I know you also volunteer as a rodeo, and I want to have rodeo events, maybe in the Southwest Houston, to work with the Cagle's office. But I want to congratulate Yvonne, you know, to have this exhibit, and I want that more people would know about this watercolor painting. One more thing I want to let you know, how important this exhibit is. When Taipei is the first Houston cities, first sister city, about more than 70 years ago. And then they do have a kind of a memorandum signed by both Mayor Turner and the Mayor Cole in Taipei. And then the Takeo office using one of the painting that Mr. Chen painted as a kind of a gift to the city of Houston. So it's very valuable thing, you know, and
his, and that is our artist Shin Zong Ho. Am I doing that close enough? Okay. His strong emotion towards this land, towards his native land in Taiwan, can be seen throughout his paintings, and his love towards the people on this land can be seen by his behavior to them. In other words, we can see emotion and we can see love of people in the artwork. And that is what art is to do. It's to evoke emotion and it's to evoke love of our fellow mankind and love of the land. And so we are delighted then to be able to present to you today the daughter of the legend, the painter who paints with emotion and love.
To present the exhibition at the Gray Center, which has been benefiting Houstonians over the years. And he is also very supportive with many events for the Taiwan American community in Houston. And secondly, I would like to thank our Chinatown Mayor, Kenneth Lee, who has always been there for me for the exhibition since 2019. And Ms. Alice Lee, who has also helped me with my first exhibition in Houston at the Downtown Public Center Library. And actually, I'm quite familiar with this center as I have attended several events here over the years, such as those held by the Houston Fuzhong Alumni Association and Teresa Zhou with HARP, and you know, many events. Art is no boundary. It can bring us together through the understanding of each other. As a Taiwan American, it's my honor to promote art among the different races. Last year was the painting donation to the city of Houston in celebration of the 60th anniversary of the Houston-Taipei sister city relationship. And this year is a painting exhibition for all Houstonians to share, with Tracy Gee being the third exhibition I have done this year. Although these were, and all these were achieved by my late father, Chen Zong Ho's lifetime effort and treasure. And I'm very happy the exhibition was recognized in June by the Taiwan Ministry of Culture. And I'm very proud of my father's paintings that are with multi-functions, not only visual and spiritual enjoyment, as most of the artworks do, but also through the paintings to introduce Taiwan's landscape, industry, as well as the deep history and fine art history. And so I've been doing a lot of, I mean, in the past two exhibitions, I've been doing a lot of, like over 30 times guided tour by request. And in this guided tour, it's mainly for the focus on Taiwan's history. And so if you need a guided tour, you can contact me. I will do it for you, either in English or in Chinese. And it was after my father's death that I started to learn about his paintings and his painting career. Because of sorting out of his relics, I was surprised that such a painter with a complete art education, experiences, and stunning artworks turned out to be my father, Chen Zong Ho. So he deserved to be well known by more people, and this is the main reason for me to keep on working on these exhibitions. And another reason is I wasn't with him for the last period of his life. I was here and he was in Taiwan, so I wanted to do something meaningful for him. And so
the question concept of sketching Chin Song Ho's life circumstances and personal motivation from painting for this event. And I'm so grateful for sharing my father's legacy and giving further context to these watercolor expressions in the wider scope of art history, and specifically in Taiwanese art history for our audience today. I hope to share with the audience the nuances that might guide an artist to devote themselves to watercolor painting, and explain the modernity of the medium at this time. As other curators and scholars have shared in the past, Chin Song Ho's greatest contribution to Taiwan's art history are his talented works and his efforts on disseminating the latest foreign fine art information and supplies in Taiwan in the 1950s. Scenic spot and historical sites are painted by almost every landscape painter, but Chin also focuses on many small local places where our daily life is. As other curators and scholars have said, Chin converted local places into magnificent scenes. It helps the establishment of Taiwanese identity in the 20th century.
正如台湾艺评家及学者所说的，陈荣和对台湾艺术史的最大贡献就是他美好的作品，以及自50年代起对于台湾南北美术讯息以及用品的提供与传播。
In this slide, we have a juxtaposition of two expressions in brushwork and artistic intent. The painting Zhongfen, the scenery is the primary subject, and we see a harmonious combination of sunlight and shadow, atmosphere, and hills steeped in architecture. There is no separation between subject and the ancient mountain town in Rifang and its environment. Chin's composition presents a snapshot of a landmark.
阳光，就是右边那一幅哈，阳光、阴影跟空气以及三区阶梯式的建筑物是和谐的组合，各个主题是合为一体的。In
contrast, the painting on the right of Xinsheng North Road, the impression of the painting makes Chin's emotions as the primary subject. The hazy color of the buildings stands in contrast to each other, and certainly in contrast to the hazy green spaces framing the bridge. I really admire the horizontal strokes that make this modern architecture. The lines seem so sharp in contrast to what we think watercolors can achieve.
主题是以左边这一幅哈，主题是以陈荣和的情感为主。那我很喜欢这个现代建筑物的横向的笔触，它的线条非常的锋利，不太像我们想象中水彩能够做得到。
This site has special memories for my father. Chin Song Ho's home during the 1970s was within walking distance to the drainage, and my sister and I played there often at many times. Chin painted it not only for memories with family, but also for keeping the scene alive before it was gone.
这幅画也是为了保有这个景观，才做的。那当然也跟他的情感，因为对于家庭生活的怀念。
The dual quality of watercolor, observational and emotional, seem to be hallmarks of many great famed watercolorists. J.M.W. Turner is arguably the most famous British watercolorist. Seems to employ the two types of painting. Here is a painting of a British port observing a scene in front of him. And here are three sketches of light effects showing atmosphere and mood of the painter as a reflection of the landscape.
这种水彩的双重特质呢，是观察性跟情感性，似乎是许多著名的水彩画家的标志。Of
course, looking at European models is important, but perhaps not the most immediate reference Chin Song Ho might have learned from. From Chin's painting career, we know that he had access to books by by early Japanese fine arts instructors in Taiwan, namely the work of Kenichiro Ishikawa, who was the lead of the fine arts program in Taiwan from 1910 to 1960 and 1920s to 1930s. Here we see a work by Ishikawa that painted a Chinese village in drab colors. The figures all seem to stand there posed for the artist, observed the artist, or suspended in their activities. The painting might have immediacy of a watercolor, but the composition shows it in a finished painting, not a quick sketch.
石川纪一郎他用黄褐色描绘了一个中国的村庄，这个村庄是在中国，China。 然后所有人物呢，似乎都站在那里为这位艺术家来摆姿势，在或者是观察艺术家，或者是他们在进行中的这个活动中停止暂停。那这幅画呢，有水彩捕捉瞬间的特色，但它的整个构图显示它是一幅完成的画作，而不是速写，不是素描。
The idea of watercolor as sketch and as finished painting is an important subject in the course of art history. I want to give a brief history of watercolor painting from the 18th century onward to, in part, explain how the watercolor is a modern or innovative medium and makes important statements in the course of art history.
水彩画被认为是速写，以及被认为是一幅完成的画作。这个议题呢，在艺术史中是一个非常重要的议题。
We will briefly travel to the three major art movements in Europe through the 18th and 19th century. Neoclassicism, paintings of historic moments, grandly recorded in oil painting, history, great myths that define morals of the nation.
新古典主义是画历史上的重要事件。
Romanticism, these artists look at real life and real people. Making large-scale paintings of these new subject matter was seen as very innovative. At this time, the artist tried to change the hierarchy of painting subject.
浪漫主义，这些是艺术家，他们着眼在真实的生活，不再画那些历史上的重要事件，而是着眼在当下的真实的生活以及人物。
Watercolor was previously a medium considered just a sketch, but some artists try to elevate watercolor's importance. This was a key moment for watercolor painting and for painting in general.
水彩画在以前呢，被认为只是一种速写，是一个画稿，是油画的画稿。但一些艺术家他们试图提升水彩的重要性。
Perhaps the most famous and the most famous are the Impressionist movement. This is when the ideas of Romanticism, painting from life, and how to paint shifted the most. Impressionists use oil painting like watercolor. They would paint a single moment quickly and try to capture the effects of light and atmosphere. Monet, painting of a train arriving at the station.
印象派运动，画家们呢，他们用油画，就像水彩画家一样，快速的画出瞬间的那一刻，试图捕捉那一刻的。
Van Gogh is one of this movement also. He is important because he painted like an impressionist, and he was also very inspired by Japanese art.
梵谷，我们大家都知道，他也是这个时期非常重要的画家。他作画呢，就像印象派画家一样，而且他还深受这个日本艺术的启发。
The left is a woodblock print by a Japanese artist in 1857. Right is a copy of Van Gogh with oil painting. Its Western artists look like Eastern art.
左边是日本的版画，是1857年的。右边是梵谷呢，模仿这幅版画，用油画颜料做的画作。那这个就是我们西方的画家在参考东方的画作。
Japan was striving to become an imperial power at this time and encouraged the cultural exchange with Europe. Many of the modern artists were inspired by Western art, and here's a slide of a woodblock print, a traditional Japanese medium, and it looks like European watercolor as inspiration.
日本这个时候呢，是他们明治维新的时候，他鼓励呢跟欧洲的文化接轨。 那所以他们许多现代的艺术家都受到西方艺术的启发。这一幅呢是1925年传统的日本版画，但是我们可以很明显的看到它是受欧洲风景水彩画的启发，因为那个画面就是画欧洲。所以这个是东方画家在参考西方的画作。
East and West were both looking at each other and also all considering the strength of different techniques for artistic expression. By the time Chen was studying painting, watercolor paintings were considered a very important technique to capture moments, painting outdoors, and expressing artists' emotions.
东西方相互对视，都在重新思考不同的艺术表现手法。到了陈荣和学绘画的时候，水彩已经是被认为是一种非常重要的捕捉景观的技巧，捕捉那一瞬间的风跟光线，而且在户外绘画以及表达艺术家的情感。Return
to Chen and Taiwanese painting, Ishikawa led art education during Japanese occupation.
石川清一郎是在日治时期，他领导台湾的艺术教育。
Taught students such as Ran Inting, who was accepted by Japanese society as a great painter. His work, On the Street, won prestigious inclusion in the Japanese-organized Teiten exhibition. His early color can be seen to match Ichikawa's mundane colors.
就是说这个蓝英鼎呢，他参加了地展。I think it's the next one. This guy is Lan Yingting. 他的画作呢，在日治时期呢有参加地展，然后所以我们从他的画作里面可以看出，蓝英鼎早期的颜色跟石川清一郎的颜色是很类似的，因为他是他的学生，他是台湾第一代的水彩画家。
Later on, Rand painted more and more village scenes, and his color palette changed to more tropical. This is actually a description of Taiwanese local color. The tropical nature of Taiwan was considered a way to depict Taiwan.
这种具有热带氛围的色调被当时呢认为是描绘台湾的在地色调。
Chen's early paintings have some resonance to Rand's work or the consideration of local color. This painting, Taiwan Village, was one of the paintings selected by the Japanese Watercolor Society. 103, painted in 1974, is not easy to create a painting as big as this dimension during the 1970s in Taiwan. Sorry, that was 73 by 103 centimeters.
因为陈荣和是属于这一派系，就是石川清一郎，然后蓝鼎，这一派系的这个水彩风景画家。那这一幅台湾农村呢，是陈荣和入选日本水彩画会的作品之一。那它有73×103公分那么大，是1974年的作品。那我记得我在台南美术馆展出的时候呢，白嘉莉有来，白嘉莉应该我们从台湾来的都知道她。
Chen is also inspired directly by European artists like Van Gogh. One of the left is Chen's painting, and there's one book of Van Gogh in front of the guitar in the painting. The right is a painting by Van Gogh from the last year of his life.
右边那一幅，就是说明了陈荣和他是很喜欢梵谷的，只是他选择的是水彩画。那右边那幅画，我们在那个吉他前面可以看到，他挂了一本书，上面就是写梵谷，那个就是一本描绘梵谷的书。The
close-up shows the importance of brushwork in Van Gogh's painting. Color, yes, but brushwork animate the composition.
在右边那一幅特写里面，显示了梵谷绘画中的动势笔触。
Some of Chen's most successful paintings have the same animation of composition from brushwork. The right one, Springtime, and Joe Finn was added in the collection of Shunwu Formosa Museum in 1997.
融合了一些经典画作，具有跟反骨一样的这种动势笔触的动画构图。那像右边这一幅呢，是左边这一幅是那个九份之春。对不起，我写错，是九份之春。那它是那个顺义台湾美术馆所典藏。Now
let's take a look more closely at subject matter. It's a key argument in Chen's paintings, present and enlivened Taiwan. Something that may not be possible in other artistic medium or by other artists. Here's a postcard that Chen painted, Scenes of Taiwan.
关键论点是陈荣和的画作呈现了一个生气蓬勃的台湾，这可能是那个年代1970年代其他媒材或者画家在那个年代做不到的。那这个是一套在1970年代陈荣和
Chen painted this during a time when Taiwanese painting also considered another type of painting as national agenda, Guohua, a literal national painting, headed by three figures that moved to Taiwan in the KMT after they lost the Civil War.
就是这三位呢，就是我们的国画名家哈，张大千，大胡子是张大千，然后右上是黄君璧，左边是那个溥儒，溥儒就是溥心畬，就是最后一个皇帝那个溥仪的亲戚的表兄弟表兄。They
worked on this in 1980 commission, the Formosa Evergreen Scroll. A 200-foot scroll that depicts Taiwan from the south to the northern tip. It was a Guohua painting that attempted to represent Taiwan after the UN revoked their recognition of the country in the 1970s. The painting toured many countries, including Australia, but never the US.
这是一幅两百英尺长的国画的卷轴，它是从南到北描绘台湾，那也正的符合，就是说台湾是从南发展到北的。那这是在联合国在1970年代撤销对台湾的承认之后，由几位就是刚刚那几位国画名家完成的，试图用它来代表台湾。It
was a movement of defining Taiwan on a grand scale. The artists toured Taiwan as a group, using planes to capture aerial footage for the first time. They worked together to compose a monumental view of the island nation. Let's look at some comparison of special locations.
这个是屏东，
the coconut. 屏东, the coconut grove. Two very different impacts. Chen's painting is an impression of coconut grove. Formosa Evergreen shows the incorporation of the groves into the village life and economy.
不好意思，不知道为什么那个陈荣和那幅那个屏东椰林不见了哈，那。 也就是说，陈的画是对椰林的印象，因为陈荣和是身在屏东嘛，那宝岛长卷图则是展现了椰林融入乡村生活以及经济的体系。就是这幅左边这幅是陈荣和对于屏东的一个椰林的印象。台北
Formosa paints a strong political central axis from presidential office building. Chiang Kai-shek Memorial Hall, Sun Yat-sun Memorial Hall, Chen shows the Grand Hotel.
所以就是说呢，是描绘一个强大的政治中轴线来代表，而陈荣和呢，则是以 圆山大饭店来代表台北。 一个是从1960年代一直到现在都是台北的地标，就是这是他们描绘的不同啊。这个宝岛长春图是一样一个政治中轴线来描绘台北，而陈荣和是用这个圆山大饭店。Alishan
Mountains. Alishan is the tallest place with the distant mountains that show people's respect for the sacred tree. Formosa shows Alishan as a small part of a larger mountain range.
我们现在来到嘉义的阿里山，陈荣和的阿里山是用远处群山来烘托它的制高点，呈现百姓对于神木的一个仰望，而宝岛长春图呢，则是将阿里山描绘成为一个更大山脉里的一个小部分。
Kaohsiung. Chin paints through the eyes of the workers on the ship and port, depicting the prosperous industry, ship demolition in Kaohsiung, and the workers' hard-working environment. Formosa presents an aerial view of the overall organization of this major economic hub.
好，陈荣和是通过这个船舶港口工人的眼睛来作画。 画的是当时高雄最兴盛的拆船业，曾经是我们台湾曾经是世界的拆船王国，那以及拆船工人们这个辛苦工作的环境。那宝岛长春图呢，则是展示了这个主要经济中心的整体组织的描看图。Formosa
seems to integrate urban and country, showing the space growing harmoniously. Chin focuses on time to the realities that construction can be disruptive. One category of his painting is the changing scenes during Taiwan's economy takeoff. It's depicted the scenery that was going to disappear. The farmland at the front that would eventually become the scene that is the background. The painting is the process of rural urbanization. These are logs soaked in a wood storage pond at the left side of the painting. This is the way to make high-value logs more durable, but it can no longer be seen now.
陈荣和比较关注是地貌的景观会因为时代的进步而破坏，甚至消失。陈荣和有一个系列是描绘台湾经济起飞时期的景观，就是描绘这种即将消失的景观。画作中前面的这个农田呢，迟早就变成后面的景观。这幅画呢，记录了 农村都市化的过程，画作的左边有一些木头浸泡在储木池，我们叫那个是储木池，这是使珍贵木材更耐久的一种方式，但是在我们的罗东，那但是现在已经没有了，因为已经不开采这个木头了嘛，这样子。Chin's
paintings show Taiwan as a circuit. Spaces that serve as a harmonious ecosystem, a balance of sites of historical, political, religious importance. If one person in a few years went up the mountain and down to the seashore and outlined lands, he created 16 paintings to represent the sightseeing of scenery in Taiwan in the 1970s.
陈荣的画作呢，将台湾展现成一个回路，所以说叫环岛。 是一个环状的生态系统，那画作呢，则涵盖了有历史、有政治、有宗教等重要的名胜古迹，并且取其平衡。那一个人，陈荣和他是一个人在数年之间，就是在1970年代上山下海，因为我们可以看到有澎湖，有阿里山，那下海的话，就是有到海边，然后有到离岛，像澎湖啦，像兰屿。 这些创作了代表台湾观光风景的16幅画作。
Formosa evergreen scrolls show Taiwan as a monumental masterpiece of urban design and natural resources. Mountain ranges give the entire island such grandeur. Linking the painting to the Shanshu painting tradition, which is mountains and river paintings, that has established landscapes as reflections of imperial reigns and scholars' minds since the 11th century. This scroll was made up by a group of people commissioned and supported by the government who worked together to create this 200-foot-long painting in a short period of time.
宝岛长春图卷轴呢，是呈现台湾城市设计以及自然资源的不朽杰作。山脉呢，是整个岛屿如此的壮观。从十一世纪以来呢，就是将山水画啊，确立为帝王统治以及人文思想的反映。宝岛长春图将这个传统连接起来。那它是由一群人在政府的委托与支援下，在一个很短的时间内，因为要代表台湾，因为那时候就中美断交嘛，然后合力创作这幅210尺长的不朽画作。
This is the most detailed mountain painting found in Chen's collection. The mountains are monumental and grand. The painting is about a site in a state of transition.From the traditional architecture in the foreground, curving to the modern building in the background, the greenery and potential for human enjoyment of nature in the foreground. Chen captures the essence of Taiwan's 20th century, a site of great growth.
这幅画呢是处于一个过渡状态的场景。那我们从前景中的这个传统建筑到背景中的现代建筑，所以说它是一个过渡时期的场景。那前景中的绿色植物呢，呈现了人类享受自然的潜力。那呈现了陈荣和他抓住了二十世纪台湾的精髓，一个蓬勃发展的美丽的宝岛。谢谢。
We still have food, and by the way, I failed to introduce earlier.Of our 7 or 8 community centers, we have the leaders of 2 of our other community centers that are here helping us today. And so visit with them and go and visit our Hockley Community Center, right here represented, and our Steve Raddick Community Center represented as well. Get some food, say hello, and thank you for joining us today.
Museum collection.
this one with the color. And I do like this one.
Oh, okay.
Because it is a Diwa's tree. Diwa's tree is very famous in Taipei. And used to be, you know, and used to be, you know, during like 1970, it already, you know, like declined. And then, you know, in 1973, the owner of there, the house owner of there, they, you know, had an agreement with the government and say, gonna, you know, because it was saving from further decline. So, gonna tear down the, you know, the widen the street. That means it's gonna tear down all these buildings that was built in the Qingdan Dynasty. And then, the second year in 1974, my father was, you know, capturing in the paintings, so trying to save the thing in his painting. Of course, you know, after 20 years, when people protect, they don't, because this is beautiful scenery, right? And it's a historical site. So then later on, they save this place, and no, they didn't tear it down. It become very famous in Taiwan now.
So, I think to Taiwan.
You have said that once my election is over with,
yes,
you're going to get me there.
The coming March is a smart city convention in Taipei. And Houston, they organize a
championship. Yes, yes. Want
to be there?
Yeah, Susan, go to the actual site.
Excellent. I'm getting the signal from Brad. It's time for me to go to my next event.
Yeah. Really?
You've been to Taiwan before, right?
No. No.
Now you have to come here, okay?
Now he has to take me to
Taiwan. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
all
right.
Let's go for that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Beautiful job.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Huh?
Thank you.
come. It's a hip show.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And did you sign?
I did.
Okay, great.
Nice to meet you.
See you. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye.